say.
All right, good evening. My name is Assistant Chief Scott Dingy of the Jacksonville Sheriff's Office Investigations Division. Tonight, a little after 4 o'clock, about 4:04, we had a double shooting at the landing behind me here. In honor of the Martin Luther King Day, we had a parade downtown approximately that ended at approximately 2 o'clock. After that event, there was another city event at Hemming Park, approximately four or five blocks away. The incident here at the landing, we don't believe has any relation to any of the official city events that were ongoing. Like I was saying, at approximately 4:04, we had two off-duty officers that were employed working inside the, hired by the landing, working as they normally do on the weekends. They heard gunfire immediately outside the doors to the landing here on Water Street. They responded outside and found two individuals that were injured, both suffering gunshot wounds. One is a 13-year-old male who is suffering from a non-life-threatening gunshot wound. The other is a 16-year-old male with a life-threatening gunshot wound. Both individuals were transported to a local hospital for treatment. At this time, I'm not releasing their names because we can't confirm that all their family members have been, or their family members in general, have been notified. So that is something that the hospital does, since they are both being treated at the hospital. So we're waiting on confirmation that the family has been notified before we release any names.
We're hearing unconfirmed reports that the 16-year-old may have passed away at the hospital. Are you guys ready to confirm that?
The last I've heard, he has not passed away, so I have not been updated any further on that. What I can say right now, as far as the shooting itself, there appears to be some kind of confrontation between a group of individuals inside or out immediately outside the landing, some kind of fight that then turned into gunfire. The incident, based on some of the individuals that we know were involved, is possibly related to the Art Walk shooting. So we are investigating that as one of our potential angles. Other than that, it's still a very active investigation, a very active crime scene. We've got a lot of witnesses to interview, other evidence to collect. So that'll be ongoing for quite some time.
Any suspect description, evidence, vehicle description?
No, there's no suspect information to put out at this time. We do have several individuals detained, and we have no suspect information besides that.
Several witnesses have said there may have been multiple shooters, possibly with automatic rifles. Is there any validation to that?
I can't confirm one way or the other which kind of firearms were used in total. We have recovered one handgun that we believe was involved. There is going to be multiple guns involved, but I can't confirm types.
What about multiple shooters?
That is possible.
Talk about how surveillance video could or is helping you guys in this.
That's one of the things that we're looking into. We're collecting different points of view from the area. There is city cameras here. There are commercial cameras nearby. So that is one of the things that we'll be checking into.
One of the witnesses tells us that he overheard a conversation with one of the victims saying, going to, an off-duty JSO officer, saying that he needed some protection, that something was getting ready to go down. Have you guys been able to look into that?
I can't confirm any of that right now. That'll be something that we check into.
Yeah, we also found a Facebook post from 9 hours ago. Someone saying that they aren't going to come here today because it's going to turn out just like the Art Walk. Were you made aware of any Facebook posts like this?
I was not made aware ahead of time. I'm not aware of anyone at the Sheriff's Office that was made aware of that. Anytime we have a situation like that, we do encourage people to call in. If word is going around on social media of potential fights or shootings or any kind of violence, please notify the Sheriff's Office ahead of time. Obviously, there is a lot of social media that we don't monitor. And so if anybody happens to see that, we do encourage people to call and tell us beforehand.
What do you say to parents as they, this is the second shooting downtown. You said it could be related to the Art Walk. After the Art Walk shooting, the sheriff came out and said this is one of the safest zones for the city. This happening on a holiday with people off, families down here. What do you say to people that are looking at this, parents that are looking at this saying, I might not take my child down here anymore?
Well, I'd say several things. First of all, statistically, this is a very safe part of town. The general public has no problem and should feel safe coming downtown to any of our events. Generally, they are very well staffed with officers, either including, in this case, off-duty officers that were hired by the landing. So in general, this is a very safe area. I will say to parents, and this has come up in several investigations lately, about children as young as 13, 14, 15 carrying firearms that their parents don't know anything about. Please, as a parent myself, monitor your kids. Make sure you know where they're going, who they're going with, and who may have what with them, because it's easy to be in the wrong place at the wrong time. The other thing I can stress is for gun owners to protect their guns. Very many of the guns that we recover in crimes like this turn out to be stolen from automobiles that weren't locked, weren't secured, and these guns end up in the hands of people that don't need them and ended up using them for horrible things.
What do you believe this was a planned attack?
I have no reason to say that other than, you know, that's one of the things that we'll look at.
What makes you to believe that this is somehow related to the shooting several days ago or up the street here?
Some of the individuals that we have identified as being present and involved.
Does it appear that shots were fired in the landing or into the landing, given the broken glass?
No, all the shooting occurred immediately outside the landing.
Did anything happen on the inside? Were there any fights or anything like that?
Not that I'm aware of, but again, that's something we'll look at with the video.
Given the fact that you mentioned the two JS, off-duty JSO officers, was there any other security present in the landing, especially given the high volume of people there today?
I don't know what the landing has for their own private security. That I just don't know.
Given the high volume of people who were inside, could this have easily been more victims, given the number of gunshots that we're hearing that would ring out?
Sure, anytime there's a large amount of gunfire, you could have multiple victims of people that were totally uninvolved, and that's always a possibility.
Could you tell us how many shots were fired?
No.
A rough estimate?
No.
And we also have sources telling us that this is possibly related to the fights that happened at the fair last year, possibly retaliation.
Again, as far as specific motivations behind everybody, that's all for us to determine in the future.
And then can you give us an estimated number of how many people you believe were out here today?
I can say right now we have approximately 30 witnesses that we're looking at interviewing that we have here inside the landing.
I know you said you guys had recovered a weapon. You recovered at least one weapon. I know you were just talking about how you're taking a lot of these guns off the street that are obtained illegally. Do you have a rough estimate of maybe of last year how many guns were actually taken off the street that were illegal weapons?
I don't have that number at hand. That's certainly something that you can contact our PIO for.
Given hindsight is always 20/20. Did it appear that maybe there should have been more of a JSO presence down here, given the fact that there were the parades and all of that?
No, there was a great deal of presence down here for the parade, for the event at Hemming Park. There was no official events going on here, so there was no reason for us to believe, you know, this would be anything but a regular, you know, day at the landing.
Does it appear that the victims may have been armed as well, that there was some sort of...
Who had what, you know, what firearms, and who had all that still under investigation?
And in the past 2 weeks, we have Art Walk and we have this. So are you guys going to reassess the security at all?
Well, that's something we do all on a daily basis throughout the city. We always monitor for any kind of increasing trends, series patterns, any of those. We do that on a daily basis anyway. Certainly this will be looked at as a potential issue.
You mentioned you had several people detained. Is there any chance any of those people who are detained right now are possibly suspects in the shooting?
That's something to be determined.
And is there any truth to what's going around about the 16-year-old having been shot in the face?
I don't want to discuss where he was shot at this point until we talk to family members and talk to medical personnel.
Any other questions? All right.
Thanks, Chief. Thanks, Chief.